Good day, everybody. Today, what we're going to study is Boolean expressions that are realized using either NAND gates alone or NOR gates alone. It is one of those kind of methods that are so easy that you end up wishing that this question would come for the exam. If you're given a function, let us straight go into the NAND gates operation, that is F is equal to A bar plus BC. If you are asked to construct the given circuit using NAND gates alone, the first step that you would do is construct the circuit as you would normally using AND gates, OR gates and inverters wherever necessary. For example, in this case, you have A bar plus BC. A bar would be A given into an inverter and taken out. This is A bar plus that is given into an OR gate here. BC. BC is given to an AND gate because B and C. So this is BC. So it is A bar plus BC given to an OR gate, and you have the answer. F is equal to A bar plus BC. Once you have constructed the AOI circuit, that is an AND OR inverter circuit, the next step comes. In this step, what we do is, you look at all the AND gates and the OR gates. Wherever you see an AND gate, you insert a bubble at the output. The point here is, insert a bubble at the output. And wherever you see an OR gate, you insert bubbles at the inputs. If you have two inputs, you insert bubble at each of the two inputs. If you have three inputs, you insert bubble at each of the three inputs. And that's all we do in the second step. We insert bubbles at output of AND gates and inputs of OR gates. The next step involves inserting an inverter for every bubble that you have inserted. The truth here is that for every bubble you have inserted, you have actually introduced a negation. Negation meaning a NOT gate. So in order to balance that, you have to insert an extra NOT gate in the circuit. So wherever you have inserted a bubble, you introduce an extra NOT gate. So you have introduced a bubble here at the output of the AND gate, you introduce the NOT gate there. You have bubbles at the input of the OR gates, you introduce NOT gates on the same line, on the same wire. Done. This is your step 3. In your next step, look carefully at the circuit. Wherever you see two NOT gates on the same wire, you can remove it. Because if you insert, you have two NOT gates on the same wire, A given to a NOT gate gives me A bar. A bar given to a NOT gate gives me A back. Therefore, it has no meaning. And therefore, we can remove two NOT gates if it is present on the same wire. I have NOT gate here and NOT gate here. Both of them are on the same wire. Therefore, I can remove it in one go. I have two NOT gates here at the output of the NAND gate here. So that also I remove. Therefore, I remove these two pairs. And what we get is this. This is what we end up with. Now, finally, we come to the next step. We apply the NAND equivalence. In applying the NAND equivalence, we have to take a note that the equivalent NAND gate of NOT gate looks like this. That means NOT gate has only one input, that is A, and the output is A bar. What if I took a NAND gate and gave the same input A to both the inputs of the NAND gate? I took a NAND gate and gave input A to both the inputs of the NAND gate. What would be the output? The output would be A and A whole bar. That is what a NAND gate does, which is actually equal to A bar itself. Therefore, this NAND gate replaces every NOT gate that I have. This is the NAND equivalence of NOT gate. For every OR gate that you have with bubbles at the input, what we have actually done is A given to a bubble is actually A bar. B given to a bubble or passed through a bubble becomes B bar. Because like I said earlier, the bubble denotes a negation or a NOT gate. So A bar and B bar are the inputs to the OR gate. So it becomes A bar plus B bar. Now by De Morgan's theorem, A bar plus B bar is equal to A dot B the whole bar, which is in fact our NAND gate. Therefore, once again, the equivalent NAND equivalent of the given setup is equal to A dot B the whole bar. The third one is a NAND gate itself. You see that when you put a bubble at the output of the AND gate, what you get is a NAND gate straightforward. So I don't have to do any substitutions here. Wherever I see an AND with a bubble, I leave it as such because that is in fact my required or requisite NAND gate. The circuit that we end up with is like this. A is given as input, then B, C to the NAND gates, and this is also a NAND gate. What you have here is all NAND gates. Good day, everybody. Today, what we are going to do is we are going to study how to draw a circuit of a Boolean expression using just NAND gates alone or NOR gates alone. It's a very easy method. Let's start. Given a function f is equal to a bar plus bc, suppose you want to do it using NAND gates alone. The first step that we would follow is like any other circuit, that is using AND gate, OR gate and inverters. My function is a bar plus bc. In order to get a bar plus bc, I pass a through an inverter, I get a bar. To get bc, I pass bc through an AND gate and I get bc. In order to get a bar plus bc, I pass it through an OR gate and I get a bar plus bc, a bar. This is the first step. Once you have obtained this circuit, we start with the second one. You insert bubbles at the outputs of AND gates. The keyword here is output of AND gates and inputs of OR gates. So wherever you see an AND gate, insert a bubble as you see here. And wherever you see an OR gate, you insert bubbles at the inputs. In this case, we have two inputs at the OR gate. So at each input of the OR gate, you insert bubbles. The next step is to insert inverters or NOT gates. Wherever you have inserted a bubble on the same wire, you insert an extra inverter. Wherever you have inserted bubbles, you insert an inverter. So I have three bubbles and correspondingly three inverters along the same lines where they were present. I have three inverters. Correct. The reason why we do this actually is because if for every bubble inserted, you are actually introducing an inverter there, which was not really present. In order to balance it out or to cancel it out or to negate the effect of it, you have to introduce another inverter. Because all of us know that if you pass a signal through two inverters, A becomes A bar and A bar becomes back to A. Therefore, the effect is nullified. So when you introduce a bubble and its inverter, you are actually nullifying the effect of the inverter that you have introduced. Now, why bother introducing these bubbles? Let us see. Before we start with the next step, what we do is we remove two NOT gates wherever it is present along the same wire. If I have two NOT gates along the same wire, as I said earlier, you have two NOT gates on the same wire, it is equivalent to the signal itself. Therefore, being present does not matter, you can remove the two NOT gates. So here I have one NOT gate here and another NOT gate here, both of them are present on this wire. I remove it. Now I have a NOT gate here and a NOT gate here, both of them are present on this wire. Therefore, their effect is nullified and I remove it. After removing it, this is the circuit that I end up with. Here I have A, the bubbles, BC given to the AND gate and the bubble here. From here, we are going to obtain the NAND gate equivalent circuit. In order to obtain that, we have to know the NAND gate equivalency of each of the bubbled gates. For example, look at the NOT gates. Okay. Suppose I have a NOT gate here, A giving A bar. In order to replace that NOT gate with a NAND gate, all you have to do is give the same input A to all the inputs of the NAND gate. We know that an inverter has only one input. So in order to give it to a NAND gate, I have to duplicate the input. So I give an A to both the input lines of the NAND gate. Therefore, it becomes A dot A whole bar, which is actually equal to A bar itself, which means that this NAND gate replicates a NOT gate. Now in my circuit, I do not have a NOT gate, therefore I will just understand this and move on to the next one. Wherever you had an OR gate, you replaced it with OR gates and preceded by two bubbles. Now what does this give us? A passed through the bubble becomes A bar. B pass through the bubble becomes B bar. Therefore, effectively, the output of this gate setup is A bar plus B bar because this is an OR gate. Okay. A bar plus B bar. According to De Morgan's theorem, A bar plus B bar is equal to A dot B the whole bar. Therefore, A dot B the whole bar is our good old NAND gate, which is what we are looking for. Therefore, this circuit that I have drawn here is in fact a NAND gate. So I get AB as the inputs to a NAND gate and the output is A dot B, the whole bar. Both of them are same. Okay. So wherever I have an OR gate with bubbles at the input, I simply replace it with a single NAND gate. Done. The third option is where you have inserted a bubble at the output of the AND gate. Just look one look at this and you realize that it is already a NAND gate. There is no work required to be done on it again. What you have is already a NAND gate. So AB is given and the output is A dot B, the whole bar, which is a NAND gate. So my circuit, I can redraw like this. A is given as input. This OR gate can be replaced by a NAND gate as we just saw right now. And here we have done the replacing. The second one is already a NAND gate and followed by a bubble. So I draw it as such. Now this is my final answer. This is the NAND circuit equivalent for the given function. How do I know whether this is true or not? Whether this is correct or not? Let's verify. Look at the function here. What I've obtained is, here it is A and here it is BC whole bar. And the output would be A and BC whole bar is given to a NAND gate. A dot BC the whole bar because it is a NAND gate. Let us try to simplify this and see if you get the original function. My original function was A bar plus BC, remember? So I get from here, A dot BC bar, the whole bar, treat the first one as X and the second one as Y. And according to De Morgan's theorem, X dot Y, the whole bar is equal to X bar plus Y bar. Let us do that. So I get A bar plus BC bar, whole bar. BC bar, whole bar is BC itself. So I get A bar plus BC, which is our original function F. Therefore, this successfully denotes a NAND gate circuit representing the A bar plus BC function, NAND gates alone circuit. Now let us proceed with the NOR gates alone circuit. Now this follows the exact same procedure as we saw for NAND gates alone, but with a very small twist. Let us do the same function A bar plus BC. You have to construct the given function using NOR gates alone. Start out with the AOI circuit, the same circuit as we saw earlier. You insert bubbles at the output of OR gates and input of AND gates. This is the difference between these two. You insert bubbles at the output of OR gates and input of AND gates. So I have inserted the bubbles at the input of AND gate and output of OR gate here. Nothing to do with the NOR gate. In the next step, like we did earlier, for every bubble that you have inserted, you insert an extra NOR gate. So there you have it. You insert an extra NOR gate for every bubble. Now if you see any double inverters, you remove it because negation, double negation is equal to nothing at all. Nothing to remove here because there are no double inverters here. Let us continue. Now we apply the NOR equivalence. Look carefully how NOR equivalence comes. For NOT gate, once again, it is a single input gate. In order to do it using NOR gate, you give duplication of A to the two inputs of the NOR gate. What you get is A plus A whole bar. That is equal to A bar itself. So that is how you replace NOT gates. In our NOT gate here, you see, you replace it like this. A is given and you get A bar. For every AND gate that you have inserted bubbles at the inputs. So it becomes effectively, the inputs become A bar and B bar. Since it is an AND gate, the output is A bar and B bar. By De Morgan's theorem, A bar dot B bar is equal to A plus B whole bar, which is actually our NOR gate, and this is what we were looking for. So for every AND gate where bubbles are inserted at the input, it is actually equivalent to a simple NOR gate, right? And for OR gates, what you have done is, you have inserted bubbles at the output of the OR gates, which is actually a NOR gate itself, so nothing to do there. So in this circuit, for every NOR gate, you insert NOR gate as seen. For AND gate and OR gate also, you insert the equivalent as we have seen here in the transformations. The final step is to verify. As you have given A to the input, this is A bar. And you have given B, this becomes B bar, C bar. B bar plus C bar whole bar, since this is a NOR gate. And this, if I simplify it, I get BC. If I give this to a NOR gate again, it becomes A bar plus BC, the whole bar. Again, pass through a NOR gate, which means it becomes whole bar again, cancels off, and I get A bar plus BC because this is effectively a NOT gate. Okay. So I hope it is clear to you guys. Please do more sums. Okay. Thank you.